Hey there, what's up, and welcome to a new series I'm calling Texture Pack Foundations. So for this series, I wanted to do a different spin on your typical Texture Pack 101 type of video. We're not going to be talking about how to make textures and pixel art and all of that, and this is not meant to be a how-to art type of video. If you're wanting to learn more about that type of stuff, I highly recommend learning the basic foundations of art, like color theory and basic drawing foundations. And there's tons of free resources online that you can use to learn more about that stuff. What I want to cover in these videos is more of the behind the scenes type of work and thinking that goes into creating a texture pack and textures. So each episode is going to cover one topic at a time. And the goal is to give you all some foundational knowledge on how I approach making my texture pack. So with that, let's kick this thing off. For this video, I wanted to cover what I think is possibly the most important concept when it comes to creating textures and a texture pack as a whole. And that concept is this: always have a goal in mind for what you're creating. Now that sounds simple enough, and you might be thinking, well duh, Pixel, why wouldn't you have a goal? And yeah, it is simple. But I think it's sometimes the simple things that we tend to dismiss and say that we're upholding and doing, but in reality, we aren't following through on them. As an example, what you're watching currently is me going through the process of editing a few textures that define this principle fairly well, I think. The textures I'm altering are the flower pot, bamboo, and dead bush textures. Now, for this principle, let's focus on the flower pot and bamboo. Before I even opened Photoshop, I sat down and just did some simple brainstorming on what I could do to alter the flower pot and give it a bit more life and variation. I recently had the chance to tour Drathmorg's world, which if you haven't seen him before, I highly recommend following him over on Twitch. He's a great builder and has a beautiful world and a charming sense of humor. During the tour, I noticed he had added in a few color variations to the flower pot to add some variety to them. After having seen that, I knew that I wanted to mimic what he'd done, but I wanted to take it a step further. I did some experimentation with putting different plants into the flower pot just to see how tall they each would reach, because I had an idea that I wanted to play around with. The idea I had was to somehow mimic the hanging pieces of wood from Kakariko Village in Zelda Breath of the Wild in Minecraft. And in order to do this, I needed a plant in a pot to reach the block above so that it looked like it was connecting or hanging off of it. After some experimentation, I found that the bamboo in the flower pot worked beautifully for this idea. And so, knowing now that it was possible, I set out to make the texture changes. Now let's pause for a moment and review. Before ever opening up Photoshop or whatever pixel pushing editor you might use, I took time to think through what I wanted to get out of these couple of textures before ever changing them. The reason I think this is the most important concept for texture making is because without establishing a goal, you're not always fully satisfied with your textures. Something just always feels like it's missing, but you can't place your finger on it. A good example from my experience would be our multiple diorite and andesite textures. I've never landed on a solid goal in mind for these textures, and because of that, I always end up getting tired of what I've created, or I take a step back and I realize that yes, that texture is decent, but that's not what I want andesite and diorite to look like. And so I end up reworking or entirely scratching the textures. So I've relatively recently started taking this goal approach more seriously when making my textures, and while it may slow my progress down a little bit, I find that the textures that I put out are 10 times more enjoyable to me than if I just jumped right into making the textures. Two great examples of textures that have been through this process are my new gravel textures and my new path textures. I absolutely love these new textures, and I give the most credit to the fact that I had a goal established for each one. For gravel, I made the simple goal of making it feel more like a natural gravel than the gravel road type of gravel that's just all rocks. There was a great example of this outside of my house that I took a lot of inspiration from. Essentially, I wanted it to incorporate dirt more while being unique from dirt in color. But I wanted it to feel more coarse and rocky and not like our coarse dirt texture. In nature, a lot of gravel blends together with dirt fairly seamlessly, and that's what I wanted from this texture, a more natural spawning rocky dirt mixture. For the path block, I simply wanted an actual dirt pathway. I've always felt that the path block looked too much like trotted on dead grass. It never actually felt like a dirt road to me, so that was the goal I set for the path block. Make it a lighter, dustier looking dirt texture that can blend well with grass, dirt, gravel, etc. I give these two examples just to show that you don't need to always come up with super in-depth goals for your textures. You just need to get some guiding principles in place so that you have an outcome you know you'll be happy with. And so we look back at the bamboo and flower pot texture, and lo and behold, we now have that Kakariko Village look as an option for decoration, and we have some colorful variations set up as well. Sure, it doesn't look exactly like Kakariko Village, but that's okay. It's Minecraft, and you have the creative freedom to make what you want. And that's the whole premise of this texture foundation video. Setting up your goals for your texture pack and your individual textures will always make your textures feel more complete and how you actually want them to be. So that is going to be it for this first texture foundation video. Let me know what you think of everything I said today, and if you have any questions you'd like me to answer as a part of this series, leave them in the comments below. I'd love to address all of them and incorporate them into the videos ahead. So with that, thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.